everybody. Enjoy yourself. Welcome, welcome, welcome to The Tonight Show. That's right. Thank you for watching. I'm very excited about this. Jennifer Lopez is my guest tonight. Jennifer and I are actually really close friends. She pops up on my phone as Jenny from the block, and I pop up on her phone as Jimmy who is blocked. And I go straight to voicemail again. And this is great. Jack Reacher himself, Alan Ritchson, is on the show tonight. Best. Alan's actually running a little late. He's stuck in the doorway of his dressing room. But it's good. We'll get him out of there. Well, guys, I hope everyone's stocked up with some beer, wings, and guac, because it's President's Day weekend. Oh, yeah! I'm looking forward. They're saying it's going to be the highest-rated President's Day weekend ever. Yep, President's Day goes back to when George Washington asked Americans to honor his birthday with huge savings on mattresses. That's right, Monday is President's Day, and I thought it'd be nice to look back at a piece of American history. So, enjoy.
The signing of the Declaration of Independence, a monumental day featuring many of the men who would go on to lead our great nation. John Adams, the second president of the United States. Thomas Jefferson, the third president of the United States. And a baby who would one day become a president himself, Joseph Biden.
I love learning about history. I do love. Well, guys, some really big news. Some really big news. Today, the judge in former President Trump's New York civil fraud trial ruled that he has to pay $355 million and is banned from doing any business in New York for 3 years. He owes $355 million. Even crazier, Trump said he's going to make Mexico pay for it. I don't understand that. That makes no sense. You can tell Trump is desperate to raise money because now it's called the AT&T Diet Coke Trump Tower. And you go, oh. Seriously, don't be surprised if 30 days Trump Tower becomes a permanent Spirit Halloween. Permanent. That's it. Of course, Trump is furious with the decision. He was like, nobody drives my companies out of business except me. That's right, Trump was banned from doing business in New York for 3 years and was fined $355 million. Could be the end of the Trump Organization as we know it. But after the news broke, some other companies reached out with some helpful words, which I thought was nice. For instance, Radio Shack said, just walk towards the light. And Blockbuster said, don't cry because it's over, smile because it happened. That's touching. Here's one, Toys R Us said, maybe it'll be back one day in some weird way that confuses everyone.
Oh, are you back?
After that, Bed Bath & Beyond said, you're about to find out what the beyond really feels like. And Time Warner said, just change the name to Spectrum and hope people think you no longer suck. Up next, JCPenney said, do what we did and just hand the keys to a family of raccoons. Run the place. It's yours. And finally, Trump water, Trump steaks, Trump vodka, Trump airlines, Trump magazine, Trump mattresses, Trump casino, and Trump university said, welcome home. We've been waiting for you. Nice of them to reach out. Well, some TV news. Apparently, Paramount Plus and Peacock have discussed combining into one streaming service. The merger could be huge. In just one place, you could find hit shows like Yellowstone and countless others. But that's true. Paramount and Peacock could merge. This feels like the last two people in a bar at closing time deciding to go home together. It's like, I'll show you my password if you show me yours. Let's go. The merger could be promising, although I'm not sure about the name. Peepeacock. And then you go, I don't know, that's... Come on, that's... I don't know.
Peepee.
Some big movie news. Marvel just revealed the cast of Fantastic Four, and everyone is excited about it. Pedro Pascal playing Mr. Fantastic. I am pumped. Are you pumped, Tariq?
Yeah, I guess I'm excited.
What do you mean?
I mean, Mr. Fantastic is cool, but... There's so many other great misters out there.
Other great misters? Like who?
Well, like Mr. T, Mr. Rogers, Mr. Burns, Mr. Bean, Mr. Miyagi, Mr. Peanut, Mr. Krabs, Mr. Clean, Mr. Spock, Mr. Mom, Mr. Feeny, Mr. Ed, Mr. Magoo, Mr. Jones, Mr. Potato Head, Mr. Pibb, Mr. Darcy, Mr. Big Brightside, Mr. Wilson, Mr. Deeds, and Mr. Worldwide. And if there's one mister who's hanging with the super, I gotta go with my main man, Mr. Cooper. But only one mister tops them all, bro. It's the OG, baby. Mr. Roboto.
I couldn't agree more. I couldn't agree more. Tariq Trotter, everyone. Come on, that's... Well, listen to this. I read that researchers in South Korea created a new kind of rice made from lab-grown meat.
Oh.
Finally, an animal-friendly way to eat rice. Yeah. I know it sounds gross, but it's actually just lab-grown rice grains infused with cow muscle and fat cells. Finally, two high school seniors have made history by becoming the first students to earn Division I scholarships for cornhole. Oh. Their parents were like, this is such a proud moment, which we won't tell anyone about. We have a great show tonight. Give it up for The Roots, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the show, everybody. Come on. Jennifer Lopez is here. Come on. Well, I do want to give a quick shout out to our very own Questlove and Tariq from The Roots. They just produced a new documentary series about James Brown called James Brown, Say It Loud. It's two parts. It airs Monday and Tuesday nights at 9 p.m. on A&E, and your production company, 215 Entertainment, teamed up with Mick Jagger to produce this.
Yeah, yep.
We got Say It Loud, you do it. James Brown got Say It Loud, let's do it.
So you get together with Mick.
That's how meetings were.
Yeah, that's how meetings were.
Yeah.
Did you learn anything about James Brown that you didn't know before?
Yeah, there's so many to mention, but yeah. Pretty much.
Can you give us a little, maybe a little
taste? We did a panel discussion after one of the screenings with Reverend Al Sharpton was one of the guests, and he gave us some insight into just, you know, so much about himself, like why he goes by the name Al Sharpton, why he wears his hair that way, and you know how James Brown was sort of like his father figure, stuff that I never really knew. I knew he was a mentor, but I didn't know, you know, to what extent, so.
Hey, Jimmy, I learned something about James Brown.
You did?
Yeah, I did.
What?
I learned that he felt good.
He didn't even know if he could. He didn't even know if he could.
Yeah. Right.
Yeah.
He didn't even know if he could.
So good.
No. So far, so good.
Yeah. Until I found you.
Anyways, check this out. This is gonna be good. Guys, what a great show we have for you today. Come on, she is one of the biggest stars on the planet. Her new album, This Is Me Now, is out today. And her Amazon original, This Is Me Now, A Love Story, is streaming on Prime Video. Jennifer Lopez is here.
Insane.
Ooh, danger. I couldn't love this person anymore.
Oh, she looks the same.
And just stunner, but just so talented.
Nice.
And just puts the work in, man. Oh. This Amazon original, this is insane. I don't even know how she found the time to do all of it. We'll talk about that. Everyone knows I love Jennifer Lopez. You know him from his hit show, Reacher, and now he's starring in the new film, Ordinary Angels, which is in theaters February 23rd. Alan Ritchson is joining us tonight. Reacher's great.
Yeah.
That movie's great.
Too. I love it.
Hilary Swank. And we got great music for one of our pals. God, he's been on our show since day one. Time, maybe even late night days.
Yeah, he was.
He's one of the best musicians around. Gary Clark Jr. is on the show tonight. JPEG Raw is the album. Hey, hey.